Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now unfortunately I wasn't able to get enough gold together in level 4 to get ourselves healed up, but thankfully level 5 has a bunch of these Trider guys, which the third spawn is a gold spawn. So, and another good thing about these guys is that they are, at least for level 5 creatures, pretty weak. Which means we'll be able to take them out without taking any damage. You just saw me pick up one of the golds, 1500 for each box, so these guys are definitely worth it. And they will give us plenty of gold to get healed up. Now before I do so, I'm going to try and find another couple of these guys, because I also want to try and get our armor upgraded. What's the last one again? Oh yeah, keys are always good. So yeah, these guys should give us plenty of cash to get our next level weapon or our next level armor and have enough to spare to get healed. Now at level 5 you have to be very careful. There's a bunch of places where you can easily get yourself stuck. So make sure you back up your SRAM files or whatever before you get here, because it's going to be a problem. One of the places you can get stuck is this one. It looks like you have to do this little jump trick and then jump down there to get into this tower. But that's not actually a tower, it's just a piece of the background. And there's no way to get out of there without destroying these walls with a Madoc. So if you don't have a Madoc, you'll be stuck there and you won't be able to continue. If you do have a Madoc, you'll have to waste a Madoc and not get anything in return. So yeah, try to avoid that. Another thing to avoid is to jump straight down from the starting area, the place we just came out of the gate. There is a big tower there, which eventually you're going to want to go to. Other than that, it's just the exit to level 4, and there's no way to get back up here. So, unless you want to either go to level 4 or clear out the big tower at the bottom, there is really no reason to jump down here. And this little three square pit is also someplace you won't get out without a Madoc, so don't fall down there. I'm not sure how strong these guys are. Pretty strong, but they drop food anyway. So we can just kill them like this. Now you saw that guy, and that wasn't one of the stronger guys in level 5. He did 3000 hit points for each hit, so yeah, that's going to be a little bit dangerous for us right now. I am going to equip my tilt spell as well. Okay, these guys use magic, but they're kind of indecisive, so not too dangerous. Just be careful not to get hit by any stray magic attacks. After you kill them, their magic will keep flying in the direction it was last going, so yeah, you have to be a little bit careful. They are very hard to see as well, because the sprites are black. That's because this guy uses a poison spell, which has the black orb as its icon. There we go. A lot of creatures in level 5 also drop pendants, so it's definitely worthwhile to kill them with your melee attacks. Pendants and Madocs are pretty common here. The reason Madocs are becoming more common is because more and more places are going to need them to... There's actually a portal, I believe, to level 6 from here that needs a couple of Madocs to get to, and there's a couple of places where you can get stuck if you don't have a Madoc, so... What the heck? I didn't know these guys drop poison. Now thankfully, we were already pretty badly damaged, so it doesn't really matter too much. But it's still kind of annoying. Let me check my notes here. Oh yep, the second spawn drops poison. I completely forgot about that. Oh well, we were low on health anyway, so no really big harm done. Just means we're gonna have to find the healer a little bit sooner. I do want to kill one more of those striders if I can, because the next one will be the gold spawn. Ooh. Snowmen. Snowmen are very strong, so be careful of those. They do a lot of damage. The worst in this level are the Myconids, which are the green guys you might have seen. But pretty much everything is dangerous to us right now. Okay, so we're going to move over here, which is going to be the shopping area, and it also... Actually, let's take out these mudmen too, because I think these guys also drop a lot of gold. Must be the second or the third spawn. We'll leave them for now. So yeah, down here is where one of these shopping areas is. And it's also where we're going to have to go to clear out our the interesting towers we want to do in this level. Now there's two towers that are pretty cool. They are small, they contain a lot of gold, and they also contain some very interesting items, so I just wanted to show you these. Alright, and the final spawn of the giant strider drops a key, which is also always nice. The trick here, of course, is to go down this block, and you will fall down the hole immediately, so after you've fallen down the block, just move to the left as soon as you can. There you go. Now you see the roof of one of the towers we want to get to. If we fall down this area, this one or this one, doesn't really matter, we will get to the shopping area first, so let's do that first. So just move down this block. As you can see, we can no longer go back up, but that's okay. And we will find our first shopping area, and also our first Myconid. Now these Myconids are extremely dangerous because they're very strong, but at the same time they also have the potential for some interesting items. The first one, I believe, drops a key. Let me just check my notes real quick. Yeah, the first one drops a key, the second one is food, and the third one is a Madoc. The final one is poison again, so you have to be a little bit careful. But there's no way we can take these out with our current health, so the first thing I want to do is get into the temple. I meant, of course, the healer. Wow, that's expensive. But there's a reason for that. We have 111,000 hit points now. Very nice. Okay, so with these guys, they all hurt us pretty bad with their melee attacks, so I'm going to use my magic to take out all but the last one. And then hopefully I'll be able to kill the last one with my halberd without taking too much damage from him. I'll try and get it from the side, but I'm not sure if that's going to be... Yeah, it doesn't really matter with these guys. Jesus Christ. Look at the damage these guys do. That's crazy. Yeah. I wonder if I have enough left for the armor. I don't think so. I think we're going to need another couple of kills before we can upgrade our armor. That's okay, we'll go into the tower first. I don't really... yeah, it's pretty expensive. I don't really want to waste... or do I? A bottle on just upgrading armor. Well, we'll see when we get out. This is one of the places I was talking about that you'll get stuck if you don't have a Madoc. There's no way out of here except by destroying that blue block over there. So you really need your Madocs in this level. Thankfully we've picked up quite a few in the previous levels, and we'll be able to pick up some more in the towers. So yeah, let's just get in here. Actually, you know what? Our time is getting a little bit short. Yeah, I think I'll cut it off here, and I'll show you the towers in the next part. Thanks for watching, guys, and see you then.